Tomorrow we'll see the 1650, which is considered the mile, even though it's not quite a mile, but that's what the athletes and everyone call that event. And they're off. They're going to build their rhythm into this race. Try to get into a good rhythm and tempo. And I think we may be able to go to an interview for part of this race. Cleary Moran is out first. 37.5. There is a very tight heat between lanes 2, 3, 4, and 5. See, now then, Moran has taken a little bit of a lead there. About a half a body. Okay, and now we're ready for our interview.
That's from Ursuline Academy. She's a junior, and she's the winner of the 100 butterfly. Megan, a 56 flat. What kind of time is that for you?
That's a good time. It's kind of similar to what I went here last year, and it's kind of where I wanted to be right now at this point in the season before sectionals.
Tell me a little bit about that third wall.
I don't know what happened, but I know that when I touched the wall, I was nose to nose with it. So that's definitely something that I need to work on, but I'm happy that I took it out fast enough that it didn't affect my race.
How did you respond on that last 25? Because you came home and won rather convincingly.
I really wanted to make up for the wall because it slowed me down a lot. So I kicked hard underwater and just came up and popped up and went for it. So.
Great. And finally, how excited are your teammates at Ursuline about this meet this weekend?
They're so excited. This is our favorite meet of the whole season, and it like really brings us closer as a team. So I'm really excited for it, and I can't wait to see like how we do today and tomorrow, and then how it carries us through the rest of the season.
Well, you've given them quite a boost here tonight. Congratulations, and good luck the rest of the weekend.
Thank you.
Top Megan. Meg is a very talented young lady. Outstanding flyer. And as we resume the race, we're about halfway through, a little over halfway, and nothing has changed. Our leader is still McCleary, followed closely by Lena Wall and Samantha. And now up in lane 7, Grace Hastings has come up. She's from Anderson, a sophomore, and really working the back half to pull ahead. You can see her right there. And she is pulling a lot of water. She's not have a very fast tempo, but her distance per stroke, very good. And she looks very powerful. And she's running away from the field. Our early leaders are still battling for second. And Grace is doing a nice job. Grace has about a 3.5-4 body length lead now. And she pulls away from the field. Good battle for second between Allison Capasti and McCleary Moran. Okay. So now we're to lap 19. And the athletes will see the all red, which means they're on their last lap. Grace is going to win this heat. It's going to be a very good time. Remember, this is a time final event, so she could move up into the top eight with this swim. 504.62. And I'd say there's a good chance that she will do so. Very happy with that win. Leanna Wall gets second, 507.55.